Creole Show, and this is Creole. Today we're going to be doing some Escovese fish with porgies. We're also going to be doing whitings, but that's going to be like, you know, a little side dish for my girlfriend. She don't like the fish with the eyes and the whole body. She likes fillets. So, yeah, but thank you for tuning in. Let's go. What's going on? It's the Creole Show. You know, we back. Today we're going to be doing some Escovese fish. I already seasoned and cleaned the fish. But now we're going to do a nice, another little seasoning touch of the flour. So this is, it has parsley, it has salt and pepper, and it has some adobo. You know, looking nice, right? Ooh, some porgy. So what we're going to do is, just going to, you know, lightly just bread it a little bit. Not too much, because you don't want to take out the taste for it. You don't want it to be too crazy, too wet, you know? But this is how we're going to do it. Make sure we dust it off. We shake off the excess flour. Excess flour.
You know, it's called excess.
Excess flour, right. Leave that right there. Got another one here.
Another seasoned one, guys.
Not too crazy. No. Nice. Nice. As you can see, tail cut off everything. Tail cut off everything. You know? And we'll be back for the frying product.
So, all right. So what's going on again, guys? I gotta show y'all something that my grandmother made me. This is you. If y'all know what Escovese fish is, this is with like cabbage, lettuce, Scotch bonnet pepper, onions, tomato. You know, not tomatoes. You know, I don't know how to say it. I don't know how to say it, excuse me, but y'all know what I'm talking about. It's these little seeds that just make it taste so good. Vinegar. If you smell, this is like a jar she made for me, man. This thing right here is super, super elite. Super elite. That's what's going on the top, and that's going to be the finishing touch for the Escovese porgy fish. Bang.
Right now, we're about to fry the porgies to make this. This is the first step for the Escovese porgy fish dish. And we're about to drop him in there. So what we're going to do is we're going to leave it for 5 minutes. We're gonna leave them for 5 minutes. Nice medium flame. Mm-hmm. On the one side, I wanna do the other. Escovese fish, first step. So, 5 minutes is almost up. We're going to flip these bad boys in just about now. Left them for 5 minutes. We're using one hand for pause, guys. Look at that. Look at that. Damn, this one is messing me up. I'm using one hand, man. I still haven't yet to get a new tripod. But look at that, look at that. Cut those bad boys is open. Amazing. Amazing. Some people cut the eyes and all that out. I leave them in, baby. I like the whole fish. I like the scenery of the fish. You dig? If you could smell it in here. It smells amazing in here, man. Like I said, I'm gonna be doing some whitings in right after. So stay tuned. Thank you. And 5 minutes is up, man. On the other side, these bad boys are looking delicious already. Let's check the other side. Delicious, delicious. Oh my God. Remember, it's my first time doing this, so. Man. Delicious. Yeah, I know y'all. I'm gonna eat you up. Delicious. So now what we're gonna do is, we're gonna remove it. Remove the two fully fried porgies. Be careful so it won't break. And we're gonna drain it. So it can be nice, dry, not dry, but you know, oil, you know, and that's how we're gonna get it. We're gonna get it like that, but it, you know, not dry out, but we don't want it to be too moist and too oily, because then we gotta put the toppings on it to excavate the fish, you know? Check me out. Okay, now it's time to flip it. Flip them, you know? You don't want them too dark, because when you let them sit outside of the oil, they tend to darken up and harden, so this should be good. So we're gonna do it one more side. Always something giving me a problem, man. My girl was said she was good at 1, 2, 3. See? Golden brown. Whiting. Filet. Smelling and looking yummy. Delicioso. So right now, these bad boys are done. We're going to take them out. Nice and golden. You see that? Check it out. And once it's out of the oil, once it's out of the oil, it starts to get more darker. They're looking good. They're looking good. Nice. Nice filet, whitey. Looking amazing. Looking amazing. Like I said, I love to cook, man. I love to cook. So, we're not done yet. We still gotta dress in the porgy to turn into husky fish. You know? My first time doing it, so pardon me for the way I pronounce it. Pros, I might be wrong, pronouncing it wrong, but I'm sorry. Nice. Ooh. Now, this is your whitings. And we look. Next second. So right now, we got the porgies fried. They're not too hot, so they're at a good temperature now. Where we have this. Remember that John showed y'all in the beginning of the video? We had the peppers. We got, it broke up, but we had the scotch bonnet peppers. You had the regular peppers and cabbage. And it was soaked and cooked in vinegar. So right now, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna put the scotch bonnet to the side, even though it's a little broke up. And we're gonna just dress the fish. We're gonna dress it. And what that is gonna do is, since it has all that vinegar taste, and all that, it's gonna soak into the fish. Let it sit. And when you eat it with it, oh my goodness. Sorry about the presentation, guys.
Scott's Bonnet Pepper. Got the mileage. But that's my Escovitz fish, man. And I would love for y'all to taste it. Oh my goodness. This thing right here. When you have it with all this on it, oh my goodness. I just broke up the pepper. Let it go all over the fish. Oh my gosh. Amazing things happening. Escovitz fish. The Creole way. On the Creole show. Alright. Subscribe. Hit that notification button. We also got the whiteys for the lady, my wife. And it's amazing here. We out here. And it's the Creole show. We out.